It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Amit.
And on this week's show, we've got three brand new products. First of all, we'll be looking at the new product by SansMinds. It's called Bound. We'll be looking at the new double DVD set from Clement and Philippe, Loving Band Redemption, and a brand new product from World Magic Shop, the Sudoku Book Test. Did I say it properly?
You said it properly.
I try to say the word Sudoku. We're debating it. Sudoku. The sofa is back as well. And Amit is on the sofa.
Hello.
Today, Amit's a great friend of World Magic Shop. You were on the Coinbexed project.
I was. And it was such a fun project to do. So I'm really happy to be here doing a Wizard product review.
And just sum up, what do you do for a living in the magic world?
So I'm a magician and a hypnotist. So I mix magic with hypnosis. I also... do hypnosis. No, I won't look at your sleep. No,
it scares me.
So I've mixed magic and hypnosis together and I have a lot of fun doing what I do. It's brilliant.
Well, hopefully this trick won't put you to sleep. See what I did there?
Boom, boom.
Here we go. Can we get it off the sticks, John? This is SansMinds' brand new effect, Bound. We're going to do a live performance.
It's going to be
more
fun.
About that in a second. Yeah. We'll talk about live performances. Can you just take a couple of those bands? Just pick them up.
There you go.
And just take them out. That's it. Check them out. Make sure they're okay.
They are. They're okay. Two rubber bands. There we go.
And do me a favour as well. Take both hands and rub them together. So kind of create some energy if you could do that. That'd be good. And just pinch your fingers together like that, your finger and thumb. And give them a little bit of a rub like that. That's good. And can you just put those two bands between your fingers? And that's good. And start to believe that you can do the magic, Amit. You can do this, seriously. You're going to do it. And just when you think the moment is right, just release one of those bands. Just one. Oh.
There you go.
And there you go. It's actually linked together. There we go.
That's quite good.
It's all right.
No, it's all right.
The thing is, what we've done for you there, we've actually done... a live performance. We wanted to show it because on the DVD, this is a little bit of a gripe of mine. You get the performance and it actually says live performance. Did you get a live performance?
No, we got a trailer, didn't we? And that's all we got.
Yes, you see reactions. Yeah, you see the guys from SansMinds doing it on people. You see them actually doing the trick. But you don't actually get a live performance. It is edited. When they do the move... You don't see it. You don't see the moment this takes place, which makes it very, very difficult. When you're trying to watch a live performance on a DVD, you're trying to sort of gain some experience about how you should perform it, the pacing of the routine and that kind of thing. You had no idea, really, how to pace it.
No, you didn't.
How to misdirect.
All they did was, obviously, as David performed on me, they got the rubber bands. They asked a spectator to pick two rubber bands, which they did. And then when he gave it back to the spectator to rub, I did it quite badly there. To be honest, I dropped the two rubber bands. But that was completely cut away, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was cut away, which means you didn't garner any sort of expertise in how to naturally misdirect.
Yes.
From this moment. What about the quality of the bands?
Well, we discussed this earlier on and we're just having a look right now. I'm not really a fan, to be honest, not only of the rubber bands, but the product itself.
They've got a thin sort of waxy texture to them when you first get them. I'm not sure if that'll wear off, but my main issue with them is the elasticity.
Yes, same here. I mean, if you have a look, it's not the best.
What happens, like you're giving that quite some welly, is when you stretch it like that, it stops.
Reaches a certain point and
it stops
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
So you don't get to sort of pull it and do anything further. And you commented that moves you use all the time... You can't actually do. Like Crazy Man's handcuffs, you could manage that. You could manage Crazy Man's handcuffs.
Just about, David. Just about manage it.
Yeah, because you've not got the same elasticity. Yeah. They say on the DVD that you can do other moves, popularised and that kind of thing. You don't get really a routine with it. Yeah. It's like an 8-minute DVD and it teaches the move that we just did and then the reveal of the bands. Quality side, again, you get sort of 10 unlinked, you get 40, I think, linked together.
It says down here, 50 pieces fully customised.
Yeah, that's it. The ones that are linked, some of them were a bit shoddy, weren't they?
They were.
we look through, and quite a few of them, you can see a join, and you can see a little bit of, like, glue.
The glue,
like, transparent glue coming off some of them. It didn't look as good. Unfortunately, you know, I'm always comparing this to Infinitum, which is another product there from Magic Soul. The quality of the bands you get with Infinitum, like, you know, you get elasticity.
Well, you can see that if you compare it, there you go. So this is Bound.
Yeah.
And this is Infinitum. And
that's your level there.
Yeah, definitely.
And for some moves, like, you always commented on the one where you make the band disappear.
Yes, I did.
And when you make the band disappear, you actually need that elasticity.
Absolutely.
If you've not got the elasticity, you can't do it. If you want to do the Infinitum move, where you've got it, like, at a distance, and then you bring it together and they link, you can absolutely forget about it with these bands. Although they demonstrate it on the trailer, their hands are very close together. Whereas one thing that really sells the Infinitum move for me is that distance you can
get between
the two bands. I agree. Value for money as a project, Infinitum is a full act. Like, literally, it's a five-minute act that is taught from start to finish, from the crazy man's handcuffs to the vanish of the band, penetrating in their hand, then the Infinitum, and then the whole link of bands going together. It's a full routine. So as far as the Linking Bands project is compared, the SansMinds project does not compare, unfortunately.
Well, we're not reviewing this today, but when we had a look at it,
we
actually enjoyed watching it, didn't we? You know, because
it's a routine.
If I'm going to buy a product, I want to make sure that whatever I'm watching, I'm getting the full thing. So I know this is how to perform it. This is how he's performing it. This is how he's done in the real world.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, with Bound, I'm not getting any of that. It's not selling for me. Another big point for me, I'm quite a big guy, let's face it. If I use these rubber bands and put it on my wrist, it fits on quite tightly.
Yeah, they're quite tight.
Compared to, obviously, the Infinitum rubber bands, which is comfortable to take off. And to be honest, you know, I would enjoy performing more with these rubber bands instead of with these.
They're just, it's weird, everybody that gets them out of the packet, and they do say it's great, because if you know other elastic band moves, you can use them. But everybody who gets them out, they all say they don't feel right.
No.
They just don't feel right, and they're very difficult
to
utilise
any other moves. Well, that's the first thing you said.
Yeah, they don't feel right. The trick's okay, but it's not as good, and you're not getting taught anything like that incredible move.
No.
I keep going on about it, but I love it, where you see the bands go through. They put it on the trailer, but all they do is say, if you know these moves, you can use them with these bands. Yes, you can, but it's difficult, and you don't get that distance. And that's the thing that makes the Infinitum trick look so good.
You don't see it happen, do you?
All they're selling, to be honest with you, John, all they're selling is the fact that it happens in the spectator's hands, and they're making it easy. But, you know, did it pass the girlfriend test? No, it didn't. I did it last night, and it was like, well, are they the same bands?
Yeah, that's it. But do you know what? I'm just reading the back of the DVD.
Yeah.
The world's first linking rubber band effect that is completely done by your spectator at their fingertips.
So that's what they're selling. But, you know, if they can say on that DVD, you know, you can utilise these bands with other things, then surely anybody else that's got a linking rubber band product out there can say the same thing. If you're aware of how to do that, if you can do that, then you can use that with these bands, because that's what they've done on their project. They've said, if you know other moves, you can do it with these bands.
Yeah.
But these bands aren't the best.
Last but not least, and if you've got OCD like I have, and I think you have, we actually counted the rubber bands.
Yes.
And how much you get in there.
Yeah.
And it says 10 normal rubber bands.
Normal.
Yeah. We got 6.
Yeah.
And 50 linking.
We sorted it out. We broke some apart and that kind of thing. But we didn't have the full quantity in there.
Yeah.
It's still okay. You do get tons in there. But it wasn't quite right once we separated them out. On the whole, pretty disappointing. The DVD looked like it had been knocked out in, like, literally an hour.
Yeah.
It was shot well, but not that impressed. How much are you going to give it?
Well, number one, looking at the way we rate stuff, I'm not going to use it in the real world. I'm not going to buy it. I'm not going to purchase it. So 10%.
I think that's fair enough. It is difficult. Look, if you're a kid and you're not confident with any elastic band moves and you just want to do that and do that very basic move, but really you should be challenging yourself. You should be trying to learn more advanced rubber band magic, really, because there's great rubber band magic. This is very simplistic.
I was just going to say that actually rubber band magic can look so magical.
More on that later.
Absolutely.
Let me give it a mark. I'm giving it 9%. I'm not impressed with the quality, not impressed with the teaching on the DVD. Didn't see a live performance, nothing that really convinced me. And the bands just don't feel right, so I can't use them.
I think John would agree with us too.
Yeah.
So now another elastic band project, but this one a little bit more fun.
We're smiling, which means this is fun.
Loving bands.
We are loving bands now. We're not hating bands, we're loving bands. Philippe and Clement are back from the critically acclaimed Effing Coins DVD and the critically acclaimed lecture at Lads a couple of years ago now.
Yeah.
Since the guys were at the Lads convention, absolutely stormed it. And they give us a taste at that convention of some of the stuff that they got coming out on this DVD. And we've been waiting for this ever since, haven't we, John?
Yeah, 2 years in the making.
So,
and I've got the pleasure of reviewing it today with David, so I'm so excited.
What did you reckon to... How did they go about presenting the DVD, Amit? First of all, how do you synopsisize that?
Well, so we put the DVD on... And it was like literally in the first few seconds we started laughing, both of us, didn't we?
Yeah.
It's a trailer. It's a proper trailer.
And well, it's a movie, isn't it?
It's a movie. It's an absolute movie. It's about, what, 23 minutes long?
Yeah. They get in their car and they go off on this journey. And they've spent some money on this. They've got, like, aerial shots and, like, it's almost like a helicopter shot following the car and that. I'm not joking.
No.
Some serious money's been spent on this. And... I think it's Phil sort of goes to sleep, doesn't he, or something?
Yeah.
He goes to sleep and he starts to hallucinate, and that's when they start dreaming, and they do some elastic band magic along the way.
And along with a lot of fun and things that are going to make you laugh so much.
So much elastic band magic. Like, you wouldn't think there was that many elastic band tricks out there.
No.
When the project was coming out, I thought, yeah, they'll probably have like 5 or 6... different bits on the DVD. There must be, what, 30 routines on here? 30 different items?
Probably more than that.
It's crazy. It's like one after another. I don't know how many individual things.
Two DVDs, 12 routines.
12 routines, 12 techniques, 3 routines bonus, making up. So about 24 different things all the way through. But it is crazy because when they say 12 routines, some of these routines are like, you know, multi-phase things happening. Like... It starts off this. If we just said the titles of the things, the first thing he did was the two bands going into one.
Oh.
And I had to watch that twice because he was doing it for two girls in bikinis.
So good.
And two bands sort of going into one. There's colour change effects. I love the eject routine, which was the one with the iPhone.
That was awesome.
Where it started on the iPhone screen, it popped off the iPhone screen, then it starts penetrating the iPhone screen. Some really freaky things were happening. Do you remember the one where it rolled up his arm?
Yeah, that was brilliant.
Like, he's actually got... It's jump, is it called? Yeah, where he's got the band around his arm. And you just, like, literally see the band just crawling up the arm, like, in a kind of eerie, sort of possessed sort
of way. It looks so good, though, didn't it?
Yeah, and then it crawls back down again. And then you're completely clean, can just take the band off. Really, really did look good.
Going back to the sort of movie, when we were actually watching Eject, it was quite funny because he took it off the phone, he did the trick, and then his phone got nicked and then went on a run to go and chase his phone. And then in between he stopped and did another magic trick, and that's when he did jump.
Yeah, you can't really sum it up, but remember he's having this dream as it's going along, so you can't really sum it up. You have to see it. All I can say is you laugh a lot while you're watching it, while you see these 12 full routines demonstrated. One of the routines that they did at the Lads Convention, John, was the F star, 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 where they have a band... And it's kind of like using that band as like a black hole.
Yeah.
And he's reaching into the band and producing objects like Sharpies. He then puts the Sharpie back in and it disappears. And then at the end, he takes his phone out of that.
Yeah.
And it just is so incredibly visual.
It's rubber band magic, but fun. And it makes you want to learn it. It makes you want to go home, put it into your DVD player, and just, even if you get a few things, few routines, a few moves from the DVD, it's going to heighten your rubber band magic up.
Just like I do. Do you do a broken and restored rubber band?
I do,
just
yeah.
The way they do it with the burnt and restored rubber band, where you actually see it and they get the person with the lighter, and then it's the way that it's done that kind of, it's burnt with a lighter, and then as you touch the ends together, you get that little bit that just flies off.
That was beautiful.
And it looks like it just goes back together. And I do a broken and restored rubber band as a finale to an elastic band thing. I kind of say, oh, this is how it's done. They're special bands. You know, you can break the bands and you can put them back together. That's how it all works. And I kind of do it at the end. It's so visual now. You know, they're actually special bands. You know, hold the lighter. If you heat them up, they'll melt apart. You can do this in your fingers, but you can just put them back together. But actually creating that more sort of magical focus moment with their version is a lot better. But the one I want to learn straight away, very simple one, might pass people by on the DVD. I forget what it was called. Do you know what it's called, John? Where the band, they hold the fingers here and the band just goes through the finger.
Yeah.
It just passes through the finger. I can't. I'll try and find a clip to put it on the screen. But for me, this was so direct. Looks like the band just goes over your finger. They hold your fingers, and it passes straight through. Absolutely fantastic.
But then other things as well, like flash band. That was awesome.
Just to start a routine.
Just to start the routine off.
Smallest piece of flash paper. Nothing else in your hands. Nothing. Completely imperceptible. Completely empty. Little piece of flash paper. Flash. And there's an elastic band.
Yeah.
Really good. Not that hard to do that as well. Not that hard to do. Looks absolutely incredible.
But even the colour changes that they were doing with the rubber bands. I mean, you know, you see colour changes with cards. You know, then you see changes with coins. I've never seen, I have seen, but the way they've done it.
The one around the phone comes to my mind, where he wrapped the colour band around the phone. He just sort of wipes it, and then the colour changes on the iPhone. There is so much on this DVD.
Yeah, band, then it changes to a triangle, then it changes to
and you commented on the flourish, didn't you, with the finger?
Yeah, I mean, I loved that. I mean, even if you do that with normal rubber bands,
yeah,
in the sense of not the starred one, but normal rubber bands, if you're going into a crazy man's handcuffs routine, I think it looks really cool.
I think it was an effect many years ago called Stargazer, where you had a normal band, then you pulled it and it became a star at the end. But with the techniques they use...
It spins around the finger.
Yeah, they kind of change it, morph it. You definitely see a normal band at the start. And then, yeah, he kind of does that move and it kind of morphs as it spins around his finger and goes back into shape. And you get that brilliant illusion. And because everything is so well shot, the colours are so rich, it looks awesome, especially, like you say, the colour changing sort of stuff. It is an inspirational product.
I mean, every magician will normally carry rubber bands on them.
Yes.
I'm sure you do.
I use rubber bands in reception all the time, yeah.
You know, and I think this has to be one of the best rubber band projects I have ever seen. It makes me want to leave the crazy man's handcuffs, go and learn something different. I mean, I work in a residency.
Yeah.
So, you know, it'll be cool for
me
to...
What sort of restaurant is it?
It's a contemporary Indian fine dining restaurant.
Right.
I'm there all the time. You know,
I was just thinking, if it was Italian, you could do that thing with the spaghetti, where he stretches the band.
Yeah.
And then he just snaps it.
Snaps
the bits. Brilliant.
But it's just so much material, isn't there?
It's a double DVD set. 12 routines, 12 techniques... Some great startling effects. It's inspirational. It makes you want to go home and start getting excited about rubber band. It's exactly the opposite of bound. It really is a fantastic project, and we are loving bound. We are really loving it. How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it a quite high percentage. So if we're going to go on the point of view of if we're going to perform it in the real world, most definitely... I think I'm going to give it about 97%.
Yeah, there's definitely a couple of things I'm going to learn for sure. I force myself to learn Infinitum because it's so strong, that link, and you can give the link bands away. There's things on this DVD I will force myself to learn because it's so strong, so simple and direct. And like you said, you can carry it around all the time.
Easy.
I'm going to give this, what did you say?
90? I said 97%.
I was going to say 99%, actually, because I know there's two things on here I've had a quick flick through the explanations. I know I want to learn these two things straight away and put them into what I do already. And I know it's going to make it stronger.
It's fair to say that on the explanation, there is no, obviously, they're not speaking.
Yes.
It's just following them. And even in the sort of movie that they do, you're just seeing them perform. But the explanations are just brilliant.
Yeah,
easy to follow.
And I think they've got a buddy of theirs that does, like, it's worth mentioning the musical score, because I think they've had a friend of theirs compose loads of music.
Yeah.
Really cool
music as well.
Yeah, and it's really good. It's really a pleasure to watch. Can't say enough about it. It is the worker of the week, obviously. And because it's the worker of the week, if you've ordered this already, you'll know this. World Magic Shop have got a special on at the moment. This special lasts till 12 o'clock on Friday this week on midnight. You will also get dispatched with your order if you order the double DVD set, Loving Band Redemption from Philippe and Clement. You will also get, by Russell Leeds, Banding Around 1 and Banding Around 2.
And it's fair to say, with these three DVDs, you're not going to need any more material than Rubber Band Magic.
Ever. Yeah, you've kind of got the lot. Unless you want to learn Bound.
Nah.
Right. There's probably something on there. I don't know. So that's it. It's this week's Worker of the Week. We've marked it. We both love it. We're loving bands. It's time now to look at a brand new product.
I am excited.
From the creative mind of Scott Creasey.
Now, I love his bit book. I absolutely love
it. You said about that, didn't you? That was the small sort of psychological testing book.
Yeah.
This is a brand new product, the Sudoku Word Search. It comes with a book and the instructions how to actually use it. The strength of this is, well, that's it. It looks like a word search book. Should we try and get this off the sticks, John, and do a couple of demonstrations here? And they can actually flick through it. It's made up of word searchers and Sudoku. Is it Sudoku?
Sudoku.
Please put it on our Facebook page, how to pronounce Sudoku.
We need a section of people for audio, so you can hear people saying it.
And at the back, it's actually got psychological tests as well. And the psychological tests can actually lead you quite nicely into the demonstration. But the nice thing about the book is, if you're using this along with other books, at the start of the presentation, they're asked to check out the books, and you say, hand me one. Okay, and we're going to use this in the explanation, in the demonstration, rather. So in this book, there's quite a few sort of puzzles, word searches and Sudoku puzzles. In fact, there's over 100. Let me see exactly how many there are. I think there's 112 in total. Amit, could you give me a number between 1 and 112?
Totally random?
Yeah.
62.
Okay, what I want you to do is turn to page 62.
Okay.
John's going to go on there and have a look at what you're doing. Go to page 62.
There we go, yep.
And is that a word search or is it a Sudoku?
It's a Sudoku.
Puzzle,
yeah.
What I want you to do is pick a square that's got three digits in it.
Okay, yep.
Three digits, and what I want you to do is think of the smallest digit in that small square. Okay? Think of the smallest digit in the square. I'm going to write something down just here. Okay, I've committed myself. Okay, what's the smallest digit?
Two,
okay. Now I'll try and think of the largest digit.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yep.
Okay, so think of the largest digit.
Yep, got it.
And that time I got 9. Is that right?
Yeah.
That's right. So I'm doing pretty good so far.
So
got
far,
2 and
so
9.
Yep.
Just think of the last digit now.
Yeah.
So I'm going to commit to that. I got 7.
Correct.
So not only did I get the digits that you thought of at random, I also got them in the same order that you were thinking of them as well, which is pretty cool. All the other squares, they're all different, aren't they?
Yes, every single square is completely different.
What I want you to do, add these digits up. So what have you got there? Is 18 added together?
Yep, got
so
18.
18. Look at the word search on the left-hand side.
Yep.
And can you look at the thing that's at number 18?
Yep.
And this might be, it could be anything. If you look through the list, there's all sorts of different sort of objects. Some are feelings, some are I don't know. Some of the things you can draw. Is this something I could draw?
Yes, you can.
Okay. Would you say this is something small or large? Is it a small object or quite a large object?
Small object.
So I'll be able to fit it on here if I drew it. Okay. Yeah. Just see that object in your mind just for a second. Okay, let's go with that. And what have you drawn? What have you drawn in your mind?
I've got cat.
A cat, and it is a cat. So you've drawn a cat. Just moving on from that as well. You've got the whole word search there.
I
haven't looked at that page yet. I don't want to actually look at it. Can you look at the first item on the page as well?
Yeah. Got it.
First item on the page.
Yeah.
And just see that object in your mind right there. Okay.
Yeah.
And are you thinking of a lion?
I am thinking of a lion.
That's awesome. I'll tell you what, open the book anywhere you like, anywhere. And but just before you do that, just remember the script. I don't think you'd ever do all these together.
No, you wouldn't.
But there's a complete act. Can you see that on the camera there, John? This is actually in the back of the books, as well as the word searches and the Sudoku tests. There's actually psychological tests in the back. Like before you do that sending the image, you can actually do this as a demonstration, sending the image of the one design inside the other one. You could do the 37 test, one number between 1 and 50, both numbers odd. But this one's quite interesting. So according to a research at Cambridge University, it doesn't matter in what order the letters in a word are. The only important thing is that the first and last letter be in the right place. This is because the human mind does not read every letter by itself, but the word as a whole.
Definitely.
It is interesting. You can use that as another sort of lead-in. And if you want, you can use the psychological tests at the end of the book as a lead-in to each demonstration. So with that in mind, open it anywhere you like.
Okay, totally random. Got it.
And what I want you to do is pick a larger word this time, something quite challenging.
Am I allowed to change the numbers around? Change them? Can I go on any page I want to?
Any page, yeah, okay. Any page.
Yep, okay.
Okay, just look at a word, but make it a big word, just quite a big word.
Yep.
Okay, and can you remember that word?
Yep.
Close up the book for me. That's great. And what I want you to do, just think of the first letter. What's the first letter? Because based on that sort of technique of knowing just one letter, you should be able to guess the rest of the word if you've got the first and the last letter. So just name the first letter.
N.
N. Okay. Just think of the last letter. Just think of it.
Okay.
Okay, how am I doing? Is that pretty close?
Not bad.
Awesome.
So far.
Think of a letter right in the middle. Right in the middle. Are you thinking of a V there?
Yeah.
That's cool. I actually got that. What word are you thinking of?
Novelty.
Novelty. There we go. And that's another test you can do with it. One other thing you can do with this book as well is use the numbers on this side. And they can use this number, these numbers right here, to form any two-digit number. And then these two-digit numbers can then be used to create a magic square. And if you create the magic square with your business card on the back, just here, it's very, very easy to do. In fact, there's no memory work at all. And that's worth saying with the whole book. There is, in fact, no memory work to do. If you do a little bit of memory work, a little bit, for one of those tests, like I just did there, you can make it a little bit stronger. The book can stay in their hands all the time. But you actually don't have to do any memory work at all if you take the pad back off them and you just write the information down on the back like you would normally. I'm sure experienced mentalists know exactly what I'm trying to say there. But that's it. That is the Sudoku book test.
There's
it really
so
is.
So many possibilities.
It's an act. It's an act. There's other things as well you can do.
It's not even, you know, that big for you to carry around if you're going to do close up.
And we're the stock of the paper is like you would buy it from
It's exactly what it needs.
I mean,
to be.
I love this bit. You know, I know you showed it at the very start.
Yeah.
But when you get the spectator to read that out, I mean, for me personally, I would love to mix that in with a bit of hypnosis.
Right.
And I could probably do that quite easily and go into an amnesia routine.
Right.
Or, you know, I'll probably end up thinking about something like
that. I like the way that that justifies asking about the first letter.
Yeah.
But by the end of it, because of the way it's structured, they think that you just got every single letter. Because you're just saying the last one, I got Y, I got, as in that case, with the word novelty. And it's really strong.
It's such a strong book, such a strong routine to do. There's about 112 pages, I think you said.
Scott, in the instructions, get the instructions with it. And yep. Scott, in the instructions, when he goes through all the effects that you can do one after another, he actually says, phew, in the instructions, it was hard to write up. And I can quite believe that, because there's so much you can do with it. You probably wouldn't do every single effect, but if you wanted to, there's near enough sort of a 20-25 minute act there.
Yeah, I mean, I've just noticed this right now, but he's even got the little touches like the pricing.
Yeah.
If you were to buy it from a shop. So he's got the US price, Canada price, the Europe price, and the UK price.
It looks
well.
Like you picked it up at an airport or somewhere Absolutely. Like that. And mix it in with a couple of other books, have one freely chosen at the start, you know, makes it very, very strong. It really is an act in itself. That's the Sudoku book test. When's that launch, Sean?
Today.
Absolutely. Launched today. 12 o'clock. On a Wednesday with the Wizard product review. So that was the first look at a brand new product. We wanted to dem it as well because it comes with the instructions. And I'm sure if you mix that in with any existing mentalism you've got, it's a very, very natural and organic object. Scott Creasey, you are a genius. I think that's a quote he's already had for the ad copy. So it says that, but that's
well,
for me.
If you've got the BIP book test or the BIP book test, I think it's, you know, you need to buy this one. I think it's fantastic.
Fantastic. Well, Amit, thank you very much for joining us this week on the Wizard Product Review. Have you had a good time?
I have.
And sorry we didn't have three great products to look at, but two very good ones. So
we've had a lot of fun and jokes and we've laughed a lot, so it's been brilliant.
No worries. Thank you very much for joining us. Until next week on the Wizard Product Review, maybe even Craig Petty will come back one day. Have we done something to upset him? I think it was so overwhelming when he was on the when Paul Daniels was here. It's just not good enough anymore to sit down with me anymore. That's it. He's going to be back very, very soon.
I spoke to him on the phone the other day. He's still alive. He's still well.
We should mention as well the Paul Daniels box set as well, John. When people order that, we've got that chopped up sort of already framed up now, haven't we? It's all ready. So if you order it, we'll be spinning that wizard wheel. And you have a chance of winning that. So until next week on the Wizard Product Review, I'm Dave.
I'm Amit.
We'll see you next week, 12 o'clock.